WF Productions 80s started at the end of 2022 with a video, Two Minds Crack, Live to Die. It is the final project of my technician's degree on radio and TV production. I mean, I call it a technician's degree because we call it a technical course here, but I'm not so sure whether it is an associate's degree or I don't really know. So I'm gonna call it a technician's degree as we call it here. Live to Die is a critic to social inequality. We had studied history, communication history, and cinema history, and I saw Charles Chaplin, Modern Times. I decided to make a critic to society, a critic to social inequality. I remember having watched this music clip by Spandau Ballet, True, this blonde guy from the early 20th century, late 19th century. And he seemed angry. He looked like one of those gangsters. And he was angry. He was wandering around the city. And it had this old London aesthetics, all this sort of stuff. And I really liked the old aesthetics, the black and white screen, all this sort of stuff. So I decided that my video was going to be black and white. And I wanted to portray this guy in the video. I wanted to edit myself into it as part of my project. Spandau Ballet did not inspire me, but this specific footage in their original music clip did inspire me. It was really cool, and that's why I decided to use it as inspiration for Live to Die. Vicious Pink, Can't You See? Yes. This song has a particular energetic beat. It has a fast rhythm, a really cool beat and all. Really cool pace, so I wanted to make one of those party videos, one of those dance videos and all. And I remember that Can't You See was very hard to make because I'd had to gather a lot of footage, around 20, 30 videos, and I had to put them together, a guy and a couple of people who want to go out and have some fun at night, and that's it. It's a good video, I really like it. One of the most popular videos in my channel is Suspicious Heart by Van Stephenson. Well, I had the idea of working with Van Stephenson's song when I first saw his album cover of the same name, Suspicious Heart, 1986. And I saw that cover there, I saw Van Stephenson wearing a suit and he had a cigarette in his mouth, and I had also shot some chroma key archive, and I thought, well, I got some footage just like that. I can make something out of it. Yeah, it might turn out into something good. So yeah, I'm gonna use Van Stephenson's song for my next video. When I read the lyrics, I thought, yes, I gotta add a girl here. There's gotta be someone to, you know, fill in the blank. I found this footage on Pexels. There was this girl, this beautiful girl. I really liked her, yes. And I thought, that's her. She's the perfect character for the video. And I made it. And it turned out really good. I think what I learned from Van Stephenson's Suspicious Heart was how to sequence scenes. This video is all about a couple, they break up. So he's angry as well because she doesn't answer him and he wants to go out and have some fun and forget a little bit about her. Maybe he's hopeless. He doesn't really think they're gonna get back together. But at the same time that she doesn't answer him, she is sad, she's crying, she is depressive, and she wants to talk to him somehow. And that's the dilemma there. And even though he goes out, he has fun at the club, he is there, but his mind is not there. His mind is with her. And he doesn't really enjoy the night because he's still thinking about her. And Ben Stephenson was really good. I really enjoyed making the video. And I turned out to make another sequence, another sequel, Every Time You Cry by Strange Ways. You wonder where it all went wrong. You never know the reason. You find yourself alone again. The couple had broken up. The guy is standing in front of the girl's house, apartment, terrace, townhouse, whatever it is, and she watches him from the window. He's down there, standing on the street, looking up at her window. They are there, looking at each other. They're sad. It's all about the lyrics. In Every Time You Cry, at the end of the video, there is this scene in which I smoke a cigarette and I wasn't really going to do anything. I was just like, just smoking and that's it. But I said, no, I gotta do something else here. This is an opportunity for me. I applied this smoke effect to the footage. I didn't really have a notion on how to use a mask, how to animate it to fade in and fade out. So I wasn't really sure at the beginning, but that was some good opportunity to learn. So I got the footage, applied the smoke, drew a mask, put some animation in. It turned out well. It's not really 100% accurate because it was the first time I ever applied the effect, but yeah, I think it was pretty convincing to me. Yes, I'm pretty satisfied with Every Time You Cry. Yeah. There's a scene in which Martin Riggs, aka Mel Gibson, shoots a sniper, and that was the best scene of the entire movie, I can tell. But it never really made into the movie, so I wanted it so bad. I wanted to use it. I didn't really have a song at the moment, but I thought, yeah, I gotta do something with Don Johnson. I gotta do something with Miami Vice. I like Don Johnson's partner as well, Michael something. I don't really remember his name, I'm sorry, but I want to do something with Miami Vice. So I'm going to use Don Johnson's music clip, blend in with Mel Gibson's footage, and I am going to edit myself into it. At the time, I was also testing a chroma key, a new chroma key style. I don't really have a green screen, so I have to improvise. I got this turquoise wall. And I was testing the footage and all. I had to edit a few times and it turned out well. Not 100% accurate, but yeah, I still could make something out of it. So in the end, I got the sky. I remember that I had first edited myself into some sort of a court grid, something like that. I didn't get what I had expected. I just put some sky behind me. There are too many clouds, and in Lethal Weapons footage, there are no clouds at all. That's a con. The pros are the rhythm, the beat, the pace. I just put the scene there, played the song, it all matched perfectly. I really love how I am in it, how Lethal Weapon is in it, how Don Johnson is in it, so I really like it very much. I think it worked pretty well, and I'm really happy with Don Johnson heartbeat. Well, I have recently made a video, The Cat Club, James is James, which is a sequel to Every Time You Cry. So in this video, that girl has got a new boyfriend and all, but she's not totally over James, the guy portrayed by me. And that starts to be an issue in her current relationship because her new boyfriend gets really jealous. Like, James, who's James? I'm not so good with names. So he gets really aggravated. He gets jealous of her ex-boyfriend for some reason. Because she still got memories and all, and she still gets upset and sad. You know, she should have been over James, but she's not. It is an issue. So the song is all about that. I got The Beach Boys, Get Your Back. The Beach Boys, It's Getting Late. And another one by Joe Boxers. Is It Really the First Time? Get Your Back has a awesome story. It's all about Jimmy, and Jimmy wants to woo this girl called Wendy. And in the video, I am there as his friend, or maybe a, what you can call a big brother, something like that. It's not really said in the video, but I guide him. I guide him through the way. Hey, man, we gotta go. We're late. You're gonna get late. Get ready. And James is all clumsy, and he stumbles on people, and is all nerdy and all, and I am there. What the hell is he doing? Whoa, man. It's crazy, man. But in the end, he woos Wendy, and it's really good. It's really good. It's Getting Late by The Beach Boys is a sequel to Get Your Back. So in that video, Wendy is this popular girl. She's got other friends. He doesn't really want to mix up with them. So I keep him company and all. Don't worry, man. She'll get back, get over her and all. Then there is this supreme surfer, surfaced. Don't really remember the word right now, who drops by. He comes out of the sea all of a sudden in the middle of the night, and we're sitting by the fire talking and chilling, and he calls Jimmy over. I'm gonna turn you into a fucking man, come on. And he's got this sort of shell. I don't really remember the instrument right now. He just turns Jimmy into a handsome man, muscular, bulky and all. Then I encourage James, go get her, man. Yeah. And it's a pretty cool movie song. Yes, I really like it very much. Now, about the technical aspects, it was... I gotta say that the hardest scenes to make were on the beach. Standing on the beach looking at the sea was very hard to make, especially sitting by the fire, because it was a night scene and the footage that I had took place during the day. I had to tweak the buttons and turn it into night, and it was very complicated. Yes, and I also had to match colors and all. I had to shoot in a new angle, so I really wouldn't remove the background. It was really complicated at the time, but yeah, you know, I used all my skill and I did it. Yeah, gotta do it.